My dear friends, tonight we gather to discuss a topic of utmost importance, the art of rebuilding and reorganizing yourself. This is not merely a guide to fixing your life. It is a profound journey into the very essence of your being, a journey that will reveal to you the immense power that lies dormant within you. Let us begin by understanding a fundamental truth. Your outer world is nothing more than a reflection of your inner state of consciousness. Everything you see, everything you experience, is a manifestation of your own thoughts and beliefs. This may seem a startling concept at first, but I assure you, it is the key to unlocking the life you truly desire. You see, most of us go through life believing that we are at the mercy of external circumstances. We think that our happiness, our success, our very well-being depends on things outside of ourselves. But I tell you now, this is the greatest illusion, the most profound misconception that keeps us bound to a life of limitation and unfulfillment. The truth, my dear friends, is that you are the operant power in your life. You are the God of your universe. This is not blasphemy, nor is it mere positive thinking. It is a scientific fact rooted in the very nature of consciousness itself. For what is God but pure consciousness, the awareness that underlies all of existence? And are you not conscious? Are you not aware? Then you too are that same consciousness, individualized in human form. Now I know that for many of you, this concept may seem too grand, too lofty to accept. You may look at your current circumstances, at the challenges and struggles in your life, and think, how can this be true? How can I be the creator of my reality when my reality seems so far from what I desire? But I implore you to set aside your doubts for a moment and consider this. Every great change, every monumental shift in human history began with a change in consciousness. Think of the great inventors, the revolutionary thinkers, the pioneers of human progress. Did they not first imagine in their minds a reality they wished to create? Did they not hold fast to their vision even in the face of a world that told them it was impossible? This, my friends, is the power of imagination. And it is the same power that you possess right now, in this very moment. But how do we harness this power? How do we rebuild and reorganize ourselves in a way that aligns with our deepest desires? The answer lies in understanding the law of assumption. This law states that if you assume the feeling of your wish fulfilled, if you live from the end as though your desire were already a reality, then that reality must manifest in your outer world. This is not wishful thinking or blind optimism. It is a principle as immutable as the law of gravity. Just as an apple must fall when released from your hand, so too must your outer world conform to your inner assumptions. The key is to make these assumptions so vivid, so real in your imagination, that they become more solid to you than the physical reality around you. Let me give you a practical example. Suppose you wish to rebuild your financial life. You may currently be in a state of lack, struggling to make ends meet. The natural tendency is to focus on this lack, to constantly worry about bills and expenses. But I tell you now, this focus only perpetuates your current state. Instead, you must assume the feeling of financial abundance. You must live in your imagination as though you already possessed all the wealth you desire. How would you feel if you were financially secure? How would you carry yourself? What thoughts would occupy your mind? These are not idle questions, my friends. They are the very keys to your transformation. For when you can answer these questions, when you can feel the reality of your desired state so vividly that it becomes more real to you than your present circumstances, then you have set in motion the forces that will reshape your outer world. But remember, this is not about daydreaming or escaping reality. It is about consciously choosing the state you wish to embody, and then living from that state with unwavering faith. It is about knowing with absolute certainty that what you have imagined must come to pass, because in the realm of pure consciousness, it has already happened. Now, some of you may be thinking, but Neville, how can I possibly feel wealthy when my bank account is empty? How can I feel successful when I've just lost my job? And to this, I say, your outer circumstances are nothing more than shadows, reflections of past assumptions. They have no power over you. unless you give them power through your attention and belief. The secret is to withdraw your attention from the unwanted circumstances and instead focus all your mental energy on the state you wish to embody. This takes practice. It takes discipline. But I assure you, it is within your power. Start small if you must. Begin by assuming a slightly improved state, one that doesn't strain your credulity too much. As you see the outer world begin to shift in response to your inner changes, your faith will grow and you will be able to make bolder assumptions. Remember, the outside world has no choice but to reflect your inner state. It is not the cause of your experience. It is the effect. You are the cause through your assumptions and beliefs. This is why no amount of action in the outer world can bring about lasting change. If your inner state remains the same, you may temporarily improve your circumstances through hard work and struggle. But unless you change your core assumptions about yourself and your pluff and your place in the world, you will invariably return to your habitual state. This is why so many people find themselves stuck in cycles of struggle and frustration. They work hard to change their outer circumstances, only to find themselves back where they started. They haven't understood that the outer world is not the source of their problems, but merely a reflection of their inner state. So how do we break the cycle? How do we truly rebuild and reorganize ourselves? The answer lies in what I call the law of revision. This law states that you can go back into your past, in your imagination, and change it. Now, I don't mean that you can literally alter past events. What you can change is your memory of those events, your interpretation of them, and most importantly, the meaning you assign to them. You see, your past is not fixed. It is fluid, constantly being reinterpreted by your present state of consciousness. When you change your present state, you automatically change your perception of the past. And since your past beliefs and experiences form the foundation of your current reality, changing your interpretation of the past can have a profound effect on your present and future. Let me give you a practical exercise to demonstrate this principle. Tonight, before you go to sleep, review the events of your day. But instead of simply recalling what happened, revise any events that were less than perfect. If you had an argument with someone, replay the scene in your imagination. But this time, see it going perfectly. Feel the harmony, the understanding, the love between you and the other person. If you faced a challenge at work, revise it. See yourself handling the situation with ease and confidence. Feel the satisfaction of a job well done. If you received news that upset you, revise it. Imagine receiving news that delights you, that confirms your highest aspirations. Do this consistently, night after night, and you will begin to see changes in your outer world. People will begin to treat you differently. Opportunities will appear where before there seemed to be only obstacles. You will find yourself naturally gravitating towards the fulfillment of your desires. This practice of revision is not about denying reality or escaping into fantasy. It is about consciously choosing the version of reality you wish to experience. This is about exercising your God-given power to select the contents of your consciousness, knowing that your consciousness is the very substance from which your world is formed. Now let us delve deeper into the process of rebuilding yourself. To truly transform your life, you must first identify the core assumptions that have shaped your current reality. These assumptions often operate below the level of conscious awareness, influencing your thoughts, feelings, and actions without you even realizing it. To uncover these hidden assumptions, pay close attention to your habitual thoughts and emotional reactions. What do you find yourself saying or thinking repeatedly? What situations trigger strong emotional responses in you? These patterns can provide valuable clues about your underlying beliefs. Once you've identified these core assumptions, the next step is to consciously choose new assumptions that align with the life you wish to create. This is where the power of imagination comes into play. You must create vivid, detailed mental images of yourself living from these new assumptions. For example, if you've identified a core assumption that life is a struggle, you might choose to replace it with life is a joyful adventure. But it's not enough to simply repeat this new phrase to yourself. You must feel it, live it, embody it in your imagination. See yourself moving through life with ease and enthusiasm. Feel the excitement of new opportunities. Experience the joy of effortless accomplishment. As you practice this, you may encounter resistance from your old patterns of thinking. This is natural and to be expected. Your current reality, with all its limitations and struggles, is deeply familiar to you. It may even feel safe, in a perverse way, simply because it's known. But remember, this resistance is nothing more than the dying gasp of your old self. It has no power over you unless you give it power through your attention and belief. The key is to persist in your new assumption, regardless of any apparent contradictions in your outer world. This persistence is what I call the faith of God. It is an unshakable knowing that what you have imagined must come to pass, because in the realm of pure consciousness, it has already happened. Now, let us turn our attention to the process of reorganizing yourself. This involves aligning all aspects of your being, your thoughts, emotions, actions, and even your physical body with your new assumptions. It's about creating a new self-concept, a new identity that is in harmony. Now, start by examining your daily habits and routines. Are they supporting your new assumptions? Or are they reinforcing your old patterns? Remember, every action you take, every word you speak, every thought you think is either moving you towards your desired state or away from it. There's no neutral ground. For instance, if you're rebuilding yourself as a successful entrepreneur, do your daily habits reflect this new identity? Do you start your day with purposeful planning and positive affirmations? Or do you immediately check your phone and get lost in social media? Do you dress and carry yourself as a successful business person would? Or do you slouch around in old, worn-out clothes? These may seem like small details, but they're crucial. Your subconscious mind is always watching, always recording. Every action you take is a vote for the type of person you believe yourself to be. Make sure your actions are voting for your desired self, not your old limiting self. This process of reorganization also extends to your environment. Look around you. Does your physical space reflect the person you're becoming, or is it cluttered with remnants of your old self? Clear out anything that doesn't align with your new identity. Create an environment that supports and nurtures your growth. This might mean decluttering your home, rearranging your workspace, or even changing the people you spend time with. Remember, you are the average of the five people you spend the most time with. Surround yourself with individuals who inspire you, who challenge you to grow, who believe in your potential even when you doubt yourself. Now, I want to address a common misconception about this process of rebuilding and reorganizing yourself. Many people believe that it requires constant struggle, that they must force themselves to think positive thoughts and take massive action. But I tell you now, this approach is not only unnecessary, it can actually be counterproductive. True transformation doesn't come from forcing yourself to be something you're not. It comes from aligning yourself with who you truly are at your core. A being of infinite potential, a individualized expression of God. When you tap into this truth, when you live from this awareness, the process of change becomes effortless. It becomes a joyful unfolding, a natural expression of your true self. This is why I emphasize the importance of feeling. It's not enough to intellectually understand these principles. You must feel them, embody them, live them, for it is your feeling, your emotional state, that is the true prayer. It is the language that your subconscious mind understands. And it is through your subconscious that you connect with the infinite power of the universe. So how do you cultivate these feelings? How do you generate the emotional state of your wish fulfilled? The answer lies in the power of your imagination. Your imagination is not some frivolous faculty for daydreaming. It is the very workshop in which your life is crafted. When you imagine, you are literally creating reality. Not in some metaphorical sense, but in a very real, tangible way. The images you hold in your mind, infused with feeling, become the blueprint from which your outer world is constructed. This is why it's crucial to make your imaginal acts as vivid and as real as possible. Let me give you a practical exercise to demonstrate this principle. Choose a desire, something you wish to manifest in your life. Now close your eyes and create a scene that implies the fulfillment of this desire. Make it as real and as vivid as possible. See the colors, hear the sounds, feel the textures. Most importantly, feel the emotion of having your desire fulfilled. For example, if your desire is for a loving relationship, you might imagine yourself lying in bed next to your perfect partner, feeling the warmth of their body, hearing their steady breathing, feeling the deep sense of love and contentment that comes from this perfect union. If your desire is for financial abundance, you might imagine yourself looking at your bank statement, seeing a balance that far exceeds your wildest dreams. Feel the sense of security, the feeling of freedom that comes with this abundance. The key is to make this imaginal act so real, so vivid, that it feels more real to you than your current circumstances. When you can do this, when you can live in the feeling of your wish fulfilled, despite any contradictory evidence in your outer world, then you have mastered the art of conscious creation. Now, some of you may be thinking, but Neville, I've tried visualization before and it didn't work. To this I say, persistence is key. You must return to your imaginal act again and again, dwelling in the feeling of your wish fulfilled until it becomes your dominant state. Remember, your outer world is nothing more than a delayed reflection of your inner state. Just as it takes time for a ship to change course, so too does it take time for your outer world to reflect your new inner state. But make no mistake, change it must. For this is the law of your being. This brings us to another crucial aspect of rebuilding and reorganizing yourselves. Patience. In our instant gratification culture, we've been conditioned to expect immediate results. But true transformation, lasting change, takes time. It requires faith and persistence. You must be willing to hold fast to your new assumption to live from your desired state, even when your senses deny it. This is the true test of faith. Anyone can believe in the visible, but it takes a truly awakened individual to believe in the invisible, to trust in the unseen reality of their imagination. When you use the beautiful paradox, when you can truly live in the end, when you can feel the reality of your desire so vividly that you no longer yearn for it because you know it's already yours, that's when it manifests most quickly in your outer world. It's when you let go of the anxiety, the doubt, the constant checking for results, that your desire can flow into your experience unimpeded. This is why it's so important to enjoy the process of transformation. Don't see it as a chore, as something you have to do to fix your broken life. See it as a joyful adventure, an exploration of your own infinite potential. For in truth, that's exactly what it is. As you embark on this journey of rebuilding and reorganizing yourself, you may find that your desires begin to change. Things that once seemed so important may lose their appeal. New aspirations may arise, ones that align more closely with your true self. This is a natural part of the process. As you shed your old limiting beliefs and align yourself with your true nature, your desires naturally evolve. You begin to want things not from a place of lack or fear, but from a place of abundance and love. This is why it's crucial to remain flexible, to be open to the wisdom of your higher self. Sometimes what we think we want is not what we truly desire at our core. Our surface desires are often shaped by societal expectations, past conditioning, or a misguided attempt to fill an inner void. But as you continue this practice of living from the end, of assuming the feeling of your wish fulfilled, you begin to tap into your true desires. You begin to align with your life's purpose, with the unique gift that only you can bring to the world. This alignment is the true goal of rebuilding and reorganizing yourself. It's not about accumulating more possessions or achieving arbitrary milestones. It's about becoming the fullest, most authentic expression of who you truly are. As you do this, you'll find that your life takes on a new quality. Synchronicities become commonplace. Opportunities seem to fall into your lap. People are drawn to you, eager to help you on your journey. This is because you're no longer swimming against the current of life, but flowing with it, aligned with the creative power of the universe. And I want to address a question that often arises when discussing these principles. What about other people? Can I use this to change someone else's behavior or to make someone love me? And to this I say, you cannot change others directly, but you change your conception of them. Remember, everyone in your world is you pushed out. They're playing the role that your assumptions have assigned to them. If you want to change your relationships, you must change your assumptions about the people in your life. For instance, if you're struggling with a difficult coworker, instead of focusing on their negative behavior, imagine them as helpful and cooperative. Feel the relief and appreciation of having such a wonderful colleague. Do this consistently, and you will be amazed at how their behavior towards you begins to shift. This is not about controlling others, but about aligning your inner world in a way that naturally evokes the best in those around you. As we near the end of our discussion, I want to emphasize a crucial point. This work of rebuilding and reorganizing yourself is not a one-time event. It's an ongoing process, a lifelong journey of self-discovery and growth. There will be times when you falter, when you slip back into old patterns of thinking and being. This is natural and to be expected. The key is not to berate yourself for these lapses, but to gently and persistently return to your desired state. Remember, you are not your thoughts, your emotions, or your circumstances. You are the awareness behind all of these things. You are pure consciousness, unlimited and eternal. This is your true identity, and it is from this place of awareness that you have the power to choose your state of being. No matter what is happening in your outer world, you always have the freedom to choose your inner state. In closing, I want to leave you this thought. The work you do on yourself is the most important work you will ever do. For as you transform yourself, you transform your world. Every shift in your consciousness ripples out into the universe, affecting not just your immediate circumstances, but the entire fabric of reality. You are far more powerful than you realize, and the life you dream of is not just possible, it is your birthright. So go forth with courage and faith. Dare to imagine the life you truly desire. Feel it, live it in your imagination, and know with unshakable certainty that it must manifest. For you are the operant power, the God of your universe, and all things are possible to you. Rebuild yourself. Reorganize your life. And step into the grandest version of who you truly are. The world is waiting for you to claim your divine inheritance.